What's up, everyone? Welcome to my channel. Today we're gonna talk about five easy drills that are gonna help your butterfly god. So those five are working in a different areas of a butterfly god, but overall they're gonna help develop a better hook game for you. And the other thing that is very good about those drills, you don't need an experienced training partner. You can just have like a white belt partner or like somebody who's just starting, and you can easily drill all five on a beginner. Okay, so first drill is a solo drill to develop proper hip movement and proper elevation movement. So we're gonna start on our side, and we have to imagine that we're in a butterfly guard, holding our controls, trying to elevate our opponent. So first thing, I keep my knee tight towards my chest. And this one is not gonna move from the beginning of the move towards the end, because we need to hold our opponent on that strong hook. If you wanna learn more about this one, check my unstoppable, unsmashable butterfly guard hook video on this channel, okay? So this one is bended. I'm gonna repeat that. Bended leg is a strong leg, okay? And then we're gonna elevate with the bottom one. So I keep my elbow tight and I come up on the bottom one. So my toes are gonna be basing on the mat, and then another point of base is gonna be my shoulder, and third point is gonna be my forehead. So first, toes actively on the mat. So I twist my foot a little bit towards the mat, put my toes there. Now I'm going on my shoulder, and third point of base is forehead. I lift, this one stays bended. I come back and I switch the side. I shrimp towards the side, the other foot on the mat with the toes, elbow tight, shoulder, and forehead. Change, shrimp back, and keep going like this. So as you can see, every time I change the side, I fix the position of my top leg, I fix the position of my bottom leg. I'm controlling the movement from the beginning towards the end. Now, second drill is gonna be about good timing with the hooks. It's a very important thing to have a good timing with your control. Not only tight control, but the control has to be fast when you're playing butterfly god. It's because the distance is so close that anytime you miss the control, anytime you're a little bit late, the opponent is already one step ahead, very close to passing your god. So your hook game has to be sharp. So that's a very good drill. The drill I really like to keep your hooks very fast and accurate. So you got your partner on his knees in front of you. And now I'm gonna get the grip on the collarbone level, and I'm gonna get the grip on the wrist. Now my partner gonna choose which leg he gonna get up with, okay? He's just gonna get up with the knee, placing the foot on the mat. Now, the thing is that I don't keep my hooks like tight there inside. I keep my legs relaxed until I feel that my partner is moving. Anytime he's putting up his leg, I'm reacting, okay? Then I'm activating the hook, and I'm coming with an active hook behind his thigh. Okay, so perfect position will be to have a hook behind his knee. Then I can create a lot of power in a sweeping movement. But during the fight, it's never that perfect. Okay, so during the fight, whatever comes. If it's gonna be in the middle of the thigh, it's good. If it's gonna be a little bit more towards the groin, it can be still good. Okay, so just to let you know that during the fight, that things are not always perfect, but what can be perfect is our timing. So then he comes back to the mat, and he's gonna choose which leg he's gonna go with the second one. Okay, so I like when my partner is trying to surprise me with the leg. So sometimes he can go like three times on one side, one time on another side, two times on this side, four times on that side. So he's always switching, and I really never know which leg he's gonna come up with. So I have to stay sharp and focused on the drill. So he's coming up, following right away, I'm here, okay? So what we try to avoid is the situation when my partner is putting his foot on the mat, I'm late, and then I'm following with the hook. Because this can be, during the fight, it can be too late, okay? Because he can already be like two steps ahead, passing my guard. So whenever he's stopping the move, I'm already following. So when he established the position of the foot on the mat, my hook is already there, active, okay? So to make it easier for myself, I like to touch with my legs, the legs of my partner. And then I'm 100% sure that I'm gonna feel whenever he's coming up. Okay, good hook behind the knee, active. Okay, that's very important as well. Don't stay loose here, because then it's gonna be easy to pass during the fight. Always active, and then we come back to the first position. He chooses another leg, active hook, one, two. Now, third drill, it's gonna be about switching the sides and fixing the position of your hips. So it's very important in a butterfly guard to always maintain a proper position of your hips, proper position of your body, and actively working during the fight to keep that position and to fix that position whenever something is wrong, okay? So we're gonna start in a classic side butterfly guard. Okay, one leg is stick to the mat, the other one is with the foot on the mat, and I'm gonna have an underhook control. So I keep my shoulder underneath my opponent's armpit, and I keep my head on this side. Okay, I can put my head here, controlling a little bit more, or I can keep it relaxed like here. Okay, but I never cross with my head towards the other side, because then it's going to be uncomfortable for me to sweep my opponent and to work with my butterfly guard. Okay, so I always keep my hips outside, and whenever I keep my hips outside, the position of my head is automatically on the right side, and it's automatically on the good side. So from here, we're gonna switch the position. So first, before I switch my hips, I have to put a little bit more control on my opponent. So here, I'm gonna put my forehead towards his neck, and I'm placing my hand on the mat. Now I'm gonna switch the side, helping myself with the hand. So I'm going one, I'm going in front of my opponent, then I'm taking out the hand from the mat, and I'm going with the underhook on the other side. Now, whenever I get the underhook, I take out the control on the belt with the first hand, and I'm placing the hand on the mat. And now this hand is gonna help me to fix my hips. I'm having a nice push from the mat, going with my hips outside, having a control on the belt. And now the only thing I have to do is to shrug my shoulder to get deep with my shoulder underneath my opponent's armpit, so he's not able to put a pressure on my arm, and then I'm fixing the position of my head. It's on the right side. Okay, I'm good to go. I can sweep from that position. And we're switching. Head control, forehead to the neck. Going in front with my hips, switching the grip on the belt, placing the hand on the mat, sliding my hips to the side, and I'm having a nice control here as well. Okay, if I need to, if I feel like the arm of my opponent is a little bit low, I'm shrugging my shoulder until I feel it's in the right position. Okay, and again, one, two, three, four, and I'm shrugging. If I need to, I'm in the right spot. So drill number four, It's for a fast entry towards the control whenever we're in front of our opponent. Okay, and my goal here now, whenever I'm in front, is to get closer to my opponent. That's one thing. And second thing, switch my hips. So now I'm gonna move forward without my hand on the mat. I have to move forward just with my legs. Okay, so I'm putting one leg a little bit in front and I'm sliding with my hips forward, just a little bit. Okay, and then I'm going with my controls on my opponent's neck and my opponent tricep, but the goal is to put the elbow in, right? So don't go too high, go a little bit more towards the elbow. And now we're gonna go with like a steering wheel move, okay? Just faking that we're gonna sweep. I'm coming back to the first position, okay? If you want to make it a little bit more like it is during the fight, try to add some hand fighting here. I'm looking for the spot to enter. I enter, doing like a steering wheel, coming back. Okay, keep the distance, fight for the grip, enter, elbow inside, head to the outside, steering wheel. You can put the hook in if you want to like feel a little bit more control and give a bit more power to the sweep, and we come back. For every five moves, I like to finish the sweep just to have like a feeling that that is still working. Okay, so every five moves, I like to finish the sweep. So elbow inside, head to the outside, hook underneath the thigh. I finish, and we come back. And again, I'm doing five. After five, I finish with a sweep. And last one, drill number five, it's to make your double underhook control better and also help you to elevate your opponent whenever you're in front position in a butterfly guard. So now what we're gonna do, we're starting in a distance. I'm gonna slide in, and I'm gonna put both underhooks underneath my opponent's armpits, okay? Whenever I do that, I lock the grip on my opponent's back. I like to have the grip like this, fingers to fingers. Some people like to have like this, palm to palm. This one works fine for me. So I keep my elbows outside, so his arms are open, and I put my forehead on my opponent's chest. Now, I'm gonna go with my hips underneath his hips, and I'm gonna use my legs to lift him up. I lift once, I put him back, and I go back to get the distance. Again, if you wanna have like a real fight, real sparring feeling, you can add some hand fighting here. So you have to work a little bit more to open up the space for yourself to go underneath your opponent's armpits. So I open up the space, I feel like I'm able to go in. To do that, I like to turn my opponent's hands a little bit towards the inside, like this. So I like to grab the palm of my opponent, turn inside, then take off the control and come in. So I get the grip on his back, high. Open up the elbow, forehead to the chest. I slide with my hips, lift him up, put him back, go back to have a good distance. So we fight here for the grip. I enter. Thank you guys for watching. Hope these five drills gonna help you improving your butterfly guard game. Drop me a comment if it does, and don't forget to subscribe. And if you like my style, butterfly guard in particular, and you like the style of my teaching, check my DVDs at BJJ Fanatics. Thank you.